Today I will be teaching you how to copy or transfer data from RDP to a local PC and from PC to RDP. I'm doing this RDP file transfer tutorial on a Microsoft Windows PC though, but you can transfer data between local computer and RDP on Mac OS and Linux operating systems by following today's tutorial. I urge you to watch this video till the end to avoid any time wasting and inconvenience. I'm not going into details on what is RDP. You are definitely well aware of the RDP, that's why you are here. If you want to transfer data with small size between RDP and local computer by drag and drop, then there should not be any problem. Copying or transferring data between 1 to 100 megabytes is no big deal. The problem arises when you want to transfer data ranging from 100 megabytes to 100 gigabytes, and on top of that, this becomes impossible if you are using a slow internet connection. I was going through the same situation while copying some important data with 3 GB size from Amazon RDP. My internet connection was not letting me copy data from Amazon RDP. After several failed attempts, I thought of file sharing websites that first upload to a file sharing website and then use given download link to download my data from the file sharing website, but gave up on this idea. Actually, there are two problems with file sharing websites. People behind file sharing websites don't allow uploading large files, as well as they impose a specific download data limit on you to stop you from downloading with maximum download speed. For an example, your internet's download speed is 1 megabyte per second, but they give you mere 200 kilobytes per second. The most annoying thing is that most of the file sharing websites don't offer resume capability. In simple words, if the internet gets disconnected, then you will have to start off your download from 0 KB no matter you were at 50 or 90%. As well as file sharing websites is not a safe method. Eventually, I decided to give a shot to peer-to-peer file sharing method, and fortunately this method worked like a charm. And I managed to transfer data to my local machine. You can do so with uTorrent, which is a free-to-use and one of the best peer-to-peer file sharing programs. You may watch my previous tutorial on how to use uTorrent if you don't know how to use it. To transfer data between RDP and local PC, download and install uTorrent on both your local computer and remote desktop. After the installation process, we need to create a new torrent file in order to transfer data between RDP and your local PC. I want to transfer this file from Amazon RDP to my local machine. Launch uTorrent and click Create New Torrent icon. You have two options here. If you want to transfer a single file, then click Add File, while Add Directory option allows you choose an entire folder to be transferred. Leave other settings as default. After choosing your data, click Create button to save .torrent file. You may give it a name. Close dialog box. Now copy .torrent file and paste into local PC. After copying, open this .torrent file with uTorrent to download or transfer data from your RDP. Keep in mind, please keep RDP turned on during all the process. You may shut down your local PC and resume download whenever you want with maximum download speed. Feel free to ask any question if you run into any problem. You can use the comment section. I'll try my best to solve your problem as soon as I can. You may find the download link in the description to download uTorrent. Stay tuned, stay blessed, and don't forget to like, subscribe, comment and share.